What's up, everybody? It's your boy Paper Drew, back with another video. If you haven't already, check out my previous video. It's a vlog of me picking up this particular shoe. You already know from the thumbnail, you already know from the description. This is going to be of the Jordan 1 Rookie of the Years. You guys already know how I do on my channel. I just do a quick overview, my impressions, do a little bit of talking, do a little bit of ranting, then of course ask for your guys' opinions. If you're new on the channel, please like, comment. If you like the content, go ahead and subscribe. I want to go ahead and give a shout out to all the new subscribers, all my old subscribers. I immensely appreciate you guys for everything that you've done so far. All my new people, all my old people, greatly appreciate it. Trying to get to 1,000 subscribers before my birthday, which is in January. That'd be a great birthday present. I think we could do it. So let's go ahead and get it. So let's go ahead and get into the shoe. As you can see here, that's the size tag. That's the particular SKU or whatever stock, whatever they want you want to call it. Got these from Foot Locker, House of Hoops. And this was a reserved pair. I told you guys how it went in my vlog. So if you guys want to see how it all went down, go ahead and check out the video. I'll leave that. I'll leave a link to that at the end of this video, at the credits or whatever you want to call it. Here they are, Rookie of the Year ones. These shoes are fire. As you can see, all the tumble, you guys have seen these already to death, but this is my video on them, how I feel about them. You got sale on the mid panels, you have that black Nike check with that pebbled tumbled look, toe box sale, same thing, that crazy leather. You got your midfoot, which is also in that sale. Then you have that Durabuck suede, that wheat color. And it's just a dope shoe, man. The quality is really good. A1 quality on this. You have the quote there from Michael Jordan. I'm not gonna read it to you guys. You guys can go ahead and pause the video and check that out. And there are his numbers from 1984, 1985. And I was able to pull these off because it has that off-white slash dunk detached wings. As you can see, they're not sewn on like regular Jordan ones, and I'll talk about that a little bit further into the video and how this is like not a normal Jordan one. And you see in the inside there, your insole is in that same wheat color with your black Nike Air. Now, talking about how these are not normal, these are really not normal. As you can see, this color, this is based off of obviously his jacket. So most of you guys already know this is based off his jacket from his acceptance speech. This is some shit that somebody would only wear in the 80s. Well, probably now too. So like vintage, that kind of stuff is coming back. But in the 80s, only somebody would be bold enough to wear this color as a jacket. Like in the 80s, like that was the thing in the 80s. People were wearing some bold shit, even though they're doing it again. But you probably would never see this particular shoe retro again. Like something like this, you're never gonna see retro again, like in this same color blocking. Like Jordan always finds a way to give us a wheat colored Jordan, whether it be a Jordan 1 or a Jordan 12 or Jordan 10 or whatever, whatever, they find a way to give us wheat around the fall and winter months. Even though here in Florida we don't get fall, we just get hot as shit and bearable. Like right now it's bearable. Like right now I can wear a black t-shirt and not feel like I'm gonna die, like honestly, like instantly turn to a puddle of sweat on sight. Like that's the only thing that we get in Florida. But for you, those of you who get seasons in the rest of the world, this is a perfect shoe, perfect fall shoe. You can switch up the laces, it would be a dope summer shoe. So speaking of laces, you got your black laces on your right foot. And of course, you get your red laces on your left foot or left shoe. Now, I'll get into the laces in a second. I did something with the laces and I'll talk about that. But if you are looking at these aftermarket, if you're going to buy them from someone, not StockX or GOAT, who verify and authenticate their sneakers, look out for that. As you can see, The left shoe is going to have the red laces. You're going to have your quality stamp which is mine is right there. Now yours is not going to be in the exact same location, and it's not probably going to have the same numbers, but just that's something to look out for. And then you're going to have on this particular pair, you're going to have this right there, which is that sticker. Now my pine greens and my core purples didn't come with that. I think my Gatorades did, but they came with a whole different box as well. So keep that in mind when you're shopping around. You're trying to get, you know, obviously you want to get some authentic shit. If you're paying money for it. Even though resale for these is not high right now, but we all know how Jordan 1s do. I'm on the cusp of that. Like size 10 is like the cut for what they call money sizes, right? So 10 and a half, usually they usually pick up a decent amount as well. But we know how Jordan 1s have done this year, especially even in the past. Like if it's something where it's got a good amount of quality and people are kind of hyped for it and it's got a decent story behind it and it means something, you know how people get. They get that FOMO, which is fear of missing out, and they will go back and prices start skyrocketing. Especially a shoe like this, like I said, this shoe, we won't get this again. We won't probably ever get the Gatorade pack again. So like shoes like this is meaningful and it's worth getting, in my opinion, because you won't see this retro again. Like we'll get Breads again, we'll get Shadows again, we'll get Royals again, we'll get the Metallics again. So those shoes, they recycle them. They find different ways to do it. Like they have the Spider-Man ones that are coming out in December, that those look like Chicago ones, but they just have like icy bottom and a little bit different, but it's essentially the same color blocking. Like we probably will even get core purples and pine greens. They'll find a way to throw purple in it and they'll find a way to throw green in it. But you probably won't ever see this again. You know, we got the all wheat ones, I think last year or something like that. But those shits were, I don't know, they were kind of weird. They're kind of ugly. As far as the quality is concerned, this shoe's quality is great. Is it better than pine greens? Is it better than core purples? Is it even better than my Gatorade ones? I could do a comparison video if you guys want to see it and let you know. But just touching the side panel here, I can tell you right now that this, when I do this on my Gatorade ones, for example, is a lot more plush and it's more, it's a lot softer on that. And even on the toe box, when I do it on my Gatorades, it's a lot softer. So they use a lot softer leather on that particular pair. This is more like the core purples and the pine greens as far as the feel of it, which those are still dope. The pine greens right now are my favorite shoe to wear. And I like green. Like green is my favorite color. But those, the pine greens, I try to find a way to wear them shits every time that I'm going out. I haven't broken out my core purples as of yet. I think I'm gonna wait for my birthday to see if I break those out, but they might not make it, but we'll see. As far as these are concerned, I did take a couple of pictures and I'll let you guys I'll see if I could do a poll. And I put in a pair of sail laces, I put in a pair of burgundy laces to try to get that peanut butter and jelly vibe, and I also put in a pair of white laces. So I had a pair of white laces, burgundy laces, and sail laces that I put in. I'll go ahead and put those pictures up really quick so you guys can see. I'll see if I could do a poll. If I could do a poll, great. I'll go ahead and do that. If not, if the poll doesn't work, then just let me know down in the comments below which one you guys like the best, and I will go ahead and do an on foot with those particular laces. But let me know down below in the comments below what you guys think. As always, man, it's been your boy Paper Drew. Like, comment, subscribe down below, not because I asked you, but because you enjoy the content. And as always, stay blessed.